The case of the Black Hills disappearances has once again been closed. The investigation was reopened last October after film reels and video cassettes supposedly belonging to the three missing film students were found by a Maryland University anthropology class. Frederick County police officials declared today that the found footage was inconclusive and that all possible leads on the case have been exhausted. Heather Donahue, Joshua Leonard, and Michael Williams disappeared in 1994 while shooting a documentary film project in the Black Hills area near Burkittsville. The three student filmmakers are still missing.
Burkittsville has only got myself and one deputy. We did the best we could. We called in the county authorities early, and we contacted the FBI later for more in-depth searching.
And I hate to publicly criticize someone in law enforcement. I was in law enforcement for 32 years. I just saw that there were things maybe that could have been done that weren't done.
I did a very good job.
Well, it seemed like that something happens about every 50 or 60 years to make the Blair Witch theory continue on. And I think that's probably what the cameramen are doing. They were hoping to carry it on in some way, and maybe they did. They may have disappeared, who knows for sure. But it's just strange that it always happens almost in a 50-year pattern that she somehow surfaces or something surfaces and leads to her.
I think they knew the legend, but I don't think they knew the whole history. I don't think they felt any fear, but I don't think they felt any kind of respect. I think to them it was just another project. It was a way to get a grade, and I think they met her, and I think she met them when she was ready to, and I think they're gone.
I am so sorry for everything that has happened, because in spite of what Mike says now, it is my fault. Because it was my project. Everything had to be my way. And this is where we've ended up. And it's all because of me that we're here now. Hungry. And cold. And hunted.
I think it's unexplained. I think it remains unexplained what happened to them. In my law enforcement career, I've seen people that have actually decided to disappear on their own and reestablish a new identity. There was no reason in this case for them to do that, and there's no indication that they did. There's never been any evidence found to show that they fell upon foul play, that they're no longer living. So it's something in between, or certainly at the very least, something very suspicious.